Hey guys, what's up? Dan here with a new video. Welcome to Project Mageblood episode 2. We started off slow with a stream of consciousness setup, but I had an itch to do something boss related, so I bought 100 gilded metamorph scarabs and I also bought compasses that guarantee a shaper or elder map once you defeat the map boss. These compasses give bosses 200% more life and 100% more damage. Add some Wrath of the Cosmos altars and you have a recipe that pretty much means one shots all over the place. If the altars were not that dangerous, I could tank one hit from the map boss, but the second hit usually meant a free teleport back to my hideout. Even though these maps were extremely hard in terms of the map boss, the rest of the map was pretty much a breeze. Go in, defeat enemies, collect the loot from the altars, assemble a metamorph at the end, rinse and repeat. Let's take a quick look at the loot. Okay guys, and here will be the loot from the 100 maps that were ran with a gilded metamorph scarab and with the charged compasses. As you can see, elder map drop on defeating the map boss, but 200% more life and 100% more damage. And you're also gonna have the altars that give the boss a 200-250 as an extra random element or maybe as extra keys. They were indeed quite hard. We're also gonna run a quick map together so that you can see how it usually went for me. But let's take a quick look at the loot first. Quite a lot of stuff, two divines and one exalt. We got a little bit lucky with an enlightened support that we dropped. We also dropped the dragon's heart, a really nice currency, and you know, pretty much the same stuff that you've been seeing from these past 2-3 farming videos. In this tab right here we have a lot of metamorph organs. I'm gonna be saving these for a future project, and in this third tab we have the maps that we have generated from the charged compasses. We have a lot of sets here, and a lot of currency has been generated by this compass right here, but please keep in mind, the maps are extremely dangerous. Let's take a quick look at the Atlas skill tree. Okay boys, and here would be our Atlas skill tree. We're going with the usual suspects: Conqueror, Shaper, Elder maps, a chance for map drop duplication, which is pretty much the only way that you're gonna be able to generate some profit out of the charge compasses that guarantee an Elder or Shaper map on defeating the map boss. These usually sell at break-even prices, and using map drop duplication, you're gonna be able to have a little bit of profit per map, actually quite a lot if you're able to duplicate most of the maps that you're gonna get. We have an 18% chance for map drops to be duplicated. You can improve this chance by going into Wandering Path, but you're not gonna be able to run the metamorphs, right? This is mostly used for farming strategies that involve running Scoured, Shaper or Conqueror maps. Besides that, as you can see, we have the increased effect of modifiers in your non-unique maps, as many mods as we could take with my 126 points that I currently have on my Atlas skill tree. We're going with the Wrath of the Cosmos. We are expecting two Essences, Shrines and Nico Packed with Energy Nodes for 3% maximum elemental resistances and 45% increased movement speed, and mining byproducts to generate a little bit of currency, I mean quite a lot of currency, because the resonators are currently selling for 3 chaos in bulk. Besides that, we are speccing into metamorph, and my recommendation would be to probably drop these 3 nodes right here, mostly because the raw metamorph, although a little bit better than in the previous leagues, is still not worth it. You're not gonna get enough loot, and most of the time it's actually a little bit more dangerous than the metamorph that you're gonna assemble at the end of the map. As for the newer nodes, I will be going with Imperfect Anatomy. This is gonna make the metamorph encounter quite a lot more manageable, and besides that, you're also gonna go with Wealth of Knowledge for a little bit of extra quantity and rarity on your metamorphs. I would not recommend unethical experiments, mostly because if you're trying to farm metamorphs, you're not trying to farm experience. They are indeed quite dangerous, so you should probably drop them from your Atlas if you're trying to level up. Let's run a quick map together. Okay boys, and for the maps we're gonna go with 4 chisels, 1 alchemy. Let's see if the mods are okay. They seem to be okay. Besides that, you're gonna use 1 rusted sulfite, 1 rusted carto and 1 gilded meta. You're gonna apply the charge compass. You should probably apply more than one if you don't want to do this every 4 maps. And then you're gonna go run the map. Summon the spiders and let's go. So as you can see, you pretty much have a free radar on your map, and we seem to be able to find the enemies for the metamorph assembly quite easily. We have found an essence. Let's use the Val Haste. Now we can tank a few hits without any issues. I'm also gonna pick up the loot so that you can see how long it takes me to run these maps. We're gonna be a little bit slow until we find the Nico Packed with Energy nodes, the Voltastic Sulfide veins, and after that we're gonna be quite a lot faster. So In this case, we're gonna go with this right here. Okay, please excuse the low FPS. I don't really have that strong of a PC. So we have the second Nikon node, which means that we're gonna be quite a lot faster. Let's summon the spiders. Should we do this? Ah no, it's actually chance for an extra sextant, guys. Really nice. Okay, so let's see if we find something. No, it's a counter thaumaturgy contract, it doesn't matter that much. Okay. So up until this point, you're gonna notice that the map is really nothing special, but you're gonna notice that the map bosses are gonna really do a lot of damage. A lot of damage, guys, to our character. Outside of Molten Shield, it's pretty much a, you know, one shot, I would say. If you have one of the altars that are gonna give the bosses some extra damage as a Chaos or as a random element. So, you know, let's also pick up the loot. And we have the Chaos Orb here. And let's go defeat the map bosses. I actually found another Skin of the Lords, which is really nice. I think we dropped two so far in these maps. And then you're gonna have to dodge, guys, okay? So dodge as much as you can. Be really careful with that guy. Okay, so far we seem to be okay. Let's give them a little bit of damage. Okay. I'm gonna try to tank a hit. A one shot. So, unless you really know what you're doing, you really shouldn't be running these maps with anything below, I would say, 15 million DPS. You could probably do it with 5 if you really know what you're doing. In my case, as you can see, if I'm really not paying attention, I'm gonna catch a 1-2 shot. As you can see, we are able to tank a one hit. So you're gonna be able to run these maps in around 4 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes, and without the sextant, I'm guessing that with this build you're gonna be able to run these maps in 3, maybe 3.5 minutes. This was pretty much the map run. Now we're gonna assemble the metamorph, and we're gonna go for the organs and the catalyst, and we should be okay here. Now I'm gonna try to face tank the metamorph so that you can notice the difference, right? So this is a tier 16 metamorph with quite a lot of, you know, area of effect, totems, and you know, whatever the map mode seem to be. But as you can see, I am AFKing, right? Yes, metamorphs are really not that dangerous compared to the map bosses that are buffed by the sextants. And as you can see, I am going for some pretty insane mods on these, you know, Wandering Guys, Sea Search, whatever these are, you know, Project Lightning and all that. Arch Nemesis, not Arch Nemesis stuff, you know what I mean. So let's try to face tank this guy as well. I'm just gonna wait here and see what happens. Okay, not gonna move. Okay, boys, and one divine is 300 kills. I'm really curious to see where this will stop. This kind of seems like a bubble to me, but anyway, let's take a quick look at the spreadsheet. This would be the currency around the 9 divines, 2 divines in the essences, around 1/3 of a divine in the rusted and the polished scarabs. We have around 3.5 divines for the gilded scarabs and other things that you're gonna notice here, including the catalysts. Please keep in mind, I'm gonna reroll these catalysts to be able to generate a lot more than what you see right here. And we have the big money makers, guys, from the Shaper sets and the Elder sets, around 20 divines. Most of this loot is actually coming from the charge compasses. So although the map bosses were extremely dangerous, one two-shotting me, I did make a lot of currency from them, so I am quite happy with the results. And this is gonna be your profit per hour right here, anywhere from 4 up to 5.5 divines per hour, depending on how fast you're able to run these maps. Most of these maps were ran in 3.5 up to 4 minutes. I would say that I made a little bit above 4 divines per hour. Please keep in mind, divines are 300 kills, guys, so I actually made anywhere from 1200 up to, I would guess, at most 1300 kills profit per hour. This is absolutely insane. Now please keep in mind, this is a medium investment farming strategy. I am investing around 29 chaos per map, but 20 of those chaoses is actually invested into the Shaper and Elder Sextant. And this is pretty much how your numbers are gonna look like if you're not gonna invest into the Shaper and Elder map compass. you're gonna be able to generate anywhere from 3 up to 4 divines per hour, which in current prices is around anywhere from 900 up to 1200 chaos profit per hour. You're gonna have to run these maps in 4 and 3 minutes. Please keep in mind, you're gonna have absolutely no issues running these maps in 4 and 3 minutes with my build and using the Nico packed with energy nodes. Although this is a slight upgrade in terms of how much currency per map we're generating compared to our previous episode, we were making around 55 chaos and now we're making 60 chaos per map, because of the Nico packed with energy nodes, we are actually making more currency per hour, and please keep in mind, exalts have gone up by quite a lot and we're able to outpace the economy by, I would say, quite a nice margin. This is a really tame farming strategy that is using around 10 chaos investment per map, and I would say that for these 10 chaos you're getting quite a lot in return. So you can use this farming strategy to generate quite a lot of loot. Maybe you could also spec a little bit into harvest, since you don't really need all of the nodes for map drop duplication. They were used because I was running the expensive compasses. So what about future plans for this farming series? Divines are absolutely insane, economy in shambles, quite a fun time. Please keep in mind, this is not the first time that this is happening. If you've played during heist, you know that prices are probably gonna come down. I expect divines to be at anywhere from 200 up to 250 chaos. Now, a sensible person would most likely hedge. So you basically take half of the loot that you have and you put it into divines, and then you take the other half of your loot and you put it into some other currencies, for example, chaos, exalts and stuff like that. However, I have a gut feeling that divines are gonna go down in price, and for this specific reason, I will not convert my chaos in exalts. I'm gonna stay in chaos, farm as many as I can, and then once the prices have settled, I'm probably gonna be a little bit closer to my mage blood than I am right now. Now, this is not something that I would recommend that you do, but in times like these, buying is usually not the best thing to do. I hope that you had a little bit of fun while watching this video. If you wanna help your boy out, drop a like and a sub. Thank you for watching, good luck as always, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.